I remember helping my friend Ben Herd, H-E-R-D, the Sausage King of Waldorf, install a bass box.
Yeah, oh yeah.
In the back of his Honda, and we absolutely fried the electric.
Yeah, because I guess it's pretty easily done, isn't it?
We ruined
it. I don't know how easily done it is, but...
Turns out you can't.
I don't mess with electric either. I do not. But we were talking, I guess, last week about remote starts, and your car had one. Josh found out that his car had one while we were on the air.
Come on. Amazing. Joe, you're the one that discovered it.
Someone texted in, and they said, hey, they sell these kits now. They're pretty easy, and they're pretty affordable. So I started doing research, and sure enough, they're affordable, and they're available on Amazon. And the term I read was plug and play.
That sounds very simple.
Yeah.
You plug and you play, like a USB cord.
And I'll tell you what, the hardest part was getting off all of the trim work. Other than that, it was simple. I did mess up at one point. I'll
describe what is the device that you bought? Has it got a brand name?
I can't remember. It's like MPC. It's just this little, I don't know what it's called, like a little black box. And you just unplug, it comes with a wiring harness, and you just unplug this one wire, like, it's got, like, those, like, multi-prong things where you, like, plug it in. So you unplug one, and then you plug the harness into it, and then you plug it back in, so, like, the harness is now part of the wiring. So you plug one in over here, you plug one in over here, there's two plugs, and then you turn the thing on, the light turns blue. And then as the light turns blue, it's like programming itself.
Okay.
And then from there, it's like it's done. All you got to do is connect like a few other wires. They go connect all the rest of the wires. So there was like a little red connection. You connect the red. There was like a blue. You connect the blue. Connect them all. And they go, test it. And the directions are very, very easy to understand. They all have pictures now. PDFs.
What was the instruction looking like? I've got some IKEA furniture that I can't figure this out.
It's incredible. It's like a PDF. You scan a code and it pops up on your phone and you're reading it and you're zooming in. And there was something else I was going to say.
You say you made a mistake.
Well, there were two connections that I wasn't using. They weren't for my application. So they were like wires with like a little connection on it.
Yeah.
And I said, well, I'm not using these. And I hate like stray wires. So I said, let me clean up the wires a little bit. So I snip these wires.
Mm-hmm. Oh, you stripped the...
No. And I don't think I should have snipped them because like when I snipped them, there might have been like a little spark.
Oh, dear.
Because on the end of them was a connector. And I should have just left the connectors there. So I snipped them just out of tidiness. Mm-hmm. And then I'm like, oh, man, I shouldn't snip those. But they're like these really super thin wires. So what I did was I went and got electrical tape, and I just wrapped them real good, like mummified them in electrical tape. And I'm pretty sure we're fine.
So when the thing is in, there it is. You got your fob. It's got to feel like the scene in the movie when I'm going to cut the red wire or the green wire. This truck is either going to start, nothing's going to happen, or I'm going to smell something.
Nah, I didn't think I would smell something because it's so easy to do. And you just hit the unlock button three times and it starts up now.
Boom.
Like it was crazy. Because I text my father who worked in the car business his whole life. And he said, man, he goes, back in the day, like we used to have to call a guy into the dealership. Yeah. He would like work on the car for like 2 or 3 hours. He'd have to wire this thing up. And that's how they put a remote start in. Now it took 10 minutes.
Here's some automotive trivia for you. What year in what vehicle was the first keyless entry? The first remote keyless system. Rose keyless system, it's called.
It's a great question, isn't it?
I had to look this up. No idea. Remote keyless system.
The 80s? Had to be the 80s.
It was the 80s. I will even give you another hint. It was not domestic.
It was a. Joe, what do you think?
I'm going BMW or Mercedes.
Yeah.
Something higher end.
Mercedes was always on the forefront of those technologies.
This car looks shockingly low rent. It is the 1982 French-produced Renault Fuego.
Yeah, I would have never got that.
The Renault Fuego was the very first car to be credited as having the remote keyless system And then it became very widespread in the U.S. in 85, 89, and it just used, like, literally radio. Used, like, now we have Bluetooth signals and stuff like that.
Well, that's like with the video you sent us earlier with them hijacking the
dude, that's
the frequency.
Crazy. These guys, I was on YouTube and it just kept like feeding me more videos and more videos. It's this guy, he's got a backpack on. I don't know what's in the backpack, but two wires are coming out of the backpack and he's holding up like this big like antenna thing. And I don't know how it does it. Like you said, it latches onto some sort of Bluetooth signal or does something and it just unlocks and like starts the car up.
Yeah, it was like a Rolls Royce or something.
Dude, you know the Dundalk neighborhood I used to live in and I miss every day when I pay my property taxes in Annapolis. Mm-hmm. When I first moved in there, shout out Hard Yacht Cafe. One of my neighbors was like, they're gonna be redoing our garages. We had a garage. I miss having a garage. I love cleaning snow off a car. It's awesome. And I come to find out that that's one of those neighborhoods that they build all the homes and then everyone moves in. And I guess one of the developers cheapied on the garage doors.
Uh oh.
And they only used like 6 signals.
Uh huh.
For 80 houses.
Right.
So you could just drive down the street with your remote thing you put on your overhead.
And open up someone else's.
Everyone. Ah! Just every 6th house, the garage door opened up. So if you wanted to, just pop it open in the middle of the night. Golf clubs,
free bike,
whatever we got, that extra TV, Christmas presents. So they go and redo all of them. Hey, Trucker Ron, what's up, pal?
What's up, buddy?
What's up, buddy? You used to
install
this stuff?
Long time ago. Yep, long time ago, I used to do stereos and remote starts in cars and stuff like that. And one day I drilled a hole in the gas tank of a car.
Whoa.
Little Honda Del Sols.
Oh,
I drilled a hole to put a screw in to hold an amp down, and it went right into the gas tank.
Oh,
and
yeah.
I didn't know it was all done. I'm like, man, I smell gas. What's going on? And that's when I realized I poked a hole in the gas tank.
That's dangerous.
Oh,
had there
no.
been a spark, you wouldn't be on the phone right now.
Yeah.
You'd be from beyond the grave, Ron. Did you tell the owners you did that, or did you just cover it up and hope they didn't notice?
Put some duct tape on it.
No, we didn't say anything. We just put a gas tank in it.
Very honorable of you.